viewers, welcome to my channel Easy Spoken English. I am Pradeep Malakar here, offering free online classes for those who want to learn English. Today's topic is preposition in complex sentences. How we can place the preposition in complex sentences. Very important. Sometimes we misplace the preposition and the sentence becomes incorrect. So it is important to know how the prepositions should be placed in complex sentences. So today's topic is prepositions in complex sentences. Let us see. First, let us see two simple sentences. This is the person I gave the money to him. This is the person I gave the money to him. These two simple sentences we can join. If we join these two simple sentences into a complex sentence, then what happens? Let us see. This is the person to whom I gave the money. Preposition to should be placed before the relative pronoun. To whom I give the money. We can also say, this is the person whom I give the money to. We can place the preposition at the end of the sentence. We can place the preposition at the end of the sentence. This is the person whom I give the money to. We can say. Again, if the connective is that, if we use that to connect the sentence, the preposition goes to the end. This is the car we came in, that we came in, that is there. So we cannot say in that, we cannot say in that. That is there, so the preposition will go to the end of the sentence. When the connective is that, the preposition goes to the end of the sentence. This is the car that we came in. There is the person we were looking for. Here, that who is this relative pronoun is omitting. Omitted relative pronoun. Relative pronoun is not mentioned, omitted. In case of omission of such relative pronouns, the preposition goes to the end of the sentence. Because there is no connective, so the preposition will go to the end of the sentence. There is the person we were looking for. When that is there, preposition goes to the end. When there is no connective is omitted, the preposition goes to the end of the sentence. Again, we cannot say such sentences. Here is the information for which you asked for. Before the connective and at the end of the sentence, we cannot use preposition. We cannot use preposition before the connective and at the end of the sentence as well. Both. So we cannot say such sentence. Here is the information for which you asked for. No. Double preposition we cannot say. We can say, here is the information for which you asked. Again, for you cannot use. Once. For. We can say, here is the information for which you asked. Or we can also say, here is the information you asked for. This is better. This expression is better expression. Here is the information you asked for. It is better to place the preposition at the end of the sentence where, because there is no connective. connective is omitted. So it is better to use the preposition at the end of the sentence. So this is all about prepositions in complex sentences. We should place the preposition at the right place. Otherwise, the construction will be incorrect. So this is all about preposition. How we can place preposition in complex sentences? If that is there, preposition will go to the end of the sentence. If the connective is omitted, preposition will go to the end of the sentence. This is the rule. The rule says so. So thank you very much for being with me. Please subscribe my channel to get regular updates and share the video so that many others can have it, can learn from it, can enjoy it. Once again, thanking you. Okay.